If you have invested your hard-earned money in Bitcoin and have successfully become a billionaire or a millionaire, is this the time that you take off our position from the largest cryptocurrency asset due to the potential destruction caused by the quantum computer? Well, that is a very interesting question, and to know the answer to the same, you are required to watch this video till the very end. Drop a like and comment below, what are your views on the quantum computer destroying Bitcoin? Hey there! My name is Alex, and welcome to AI News Daily. In today's video, we are going to talk about the new Google supremacy and its likeliness to destroy Bitcoin as the potential news of achieving a quantum computer is on its way. So, before we begin, please be reminded this is only an informative video and is not financial advice. You are requested to consult with experts in this regard to manage your crypto asset finances well. With that being said, let's begin. Investors from far and ahead have come together to invest in something that can potentially destroy Bitcoin, and when we say Bitcoin, it practically means it will hold the capacity to eradicate more than half of the crypto assets linked with Bitcoin. Now, your first question will be how and why? To answer this, let's start with what a quantum computer is and how and where it is being created. In physics terminology, quantum computers are simple machines that will use the properties of quantum physics to store data and perform computations. In physics, the theory of quantum is revolutionary. In 1900, physicist Max Planck introduced individual units like matter and called it quanta. In 1905, Albert Einstein added to Planck's definition and declared that radiation also has quantifiable smaller units. In 1927, Werner Heisenberg stated the uncertainty principle to measure two complementary values. Quantum computers can solve exponential equations significantly faster and need less energy. On 30th November 2021, CNET.com came up with a new article that read, "Quantum Computing Heavyweight Arrives as Merger Creates Quantinuum." In this article, we came to know that Honeywell Quantum Solutions and Cambridge Quantum, two of the world's biggest technology companies in the nicest, have plans to come together and merge and become a new company known as the Quantinuum, which will potentially be working to create the revolutionary quantum computing technology. Honeywell Quantum Solutions is a subsidiary company of Honeywell, an industrial giant who used to sell the mainframe business in 1986 and is currently active in the field of aerospace, chemicals, and building management. Cambridge Quantum is a UK-based company that operates on the software needed to make quantum computers for regular customers. Ilyas Khan, the founder of Cambridge Quantum and also the chief executive of Quantinuum, says, "We will be a center of gravity for the entire industry." Towards this merger, Bob Sorensen, Hyperion research analyst, predicts that this merger would move forward the full stack of quantum computing technology that will be preferred by the customers over cobbling together technology elements from multiple suppliers. We are still in the early stages of a shakeout in the sector. Consolidation and collaboration to move to some form of a full stack offering is a big ticket to do for many quantum computing players at this point. Now, let's make this clear. Do you think this computing technology will be available at your home desktop or laptop? If yes, you are wrong. We will not be direct customers because, firstly, these quantum computers will not fit on your desktop or laptop. However, they will be active in the way of operating in data centers to check the efficiency of solar panels, the financial performance, and the development of new machines and technologies. Are you still here and not subscribed yet? What are you waiting for? Press the subscribe button now. Coming to the major question, can quantum computers affect Bitcoin? Well, from a science and technology perspective, the answer would be a definite yes. Ever since the concept of cryptography has come along, the elliptic curve cryptography has been under surveillance since the quantum computing excitement began. Now, why did Bitcoin come into existence in the first place? Bitcoin was built to stop third parties from being active members in financial transactions with the help of cryptographic proof. But Bitcoin is a very small universe compared to the two major ecosystems, Revest Shamir Adelman and elliptic curve cryptography. Well, no matter how big these ecosystems are, they are not saved or immune from the attacks of quantum computers. Both of them are susceptible to quantum computer assaults. Anyone communicating online will face a security concern if a large enough quantum computer is built. What would happen if a quantum computer could destabilize the cryptography that underpins digital currencies? Quantum computing's potential impact on currencies will be determined by the currency's implementation details and how exchanges handle transactions and wallets. The technology of encryption works with the application of a mathematical formula and scrambling the same so that only the person needed can see it. RSA relies on factoring numbers. Taking a large number and factoring it to get those two prime numbers is more difficult than multiplying two prime numbers. In 1995, Peter Shor proposed a polynomial time quantum method, which we now refer to as Shor's algorithm. It demonstrated how, as compared to a classical technique, the new algorithm uses far fewer operations to tackle a huge prime factorization problem. A powerful quantum computer executing Shor's algorithm might, in theory, solve such a task in a matter of days, which a classic computer will take billions of years to solve. Shor's algorithm can find the prime factors of a number and can undo the problem much more easily than a regular computer. This means that someone with a powerful enough quantum computer might theoretically extract your private key from the public key. This is a significant issue, because a private key can be used to authorize transactions that the owner does not want to happen. It should never be shared with anybody. As quantum computers improve, the security of RSA will be rendered obsolete. Shor's discrete logarithm quantum algorithm will impact ECC as well. Coming to Bitcoin, blockchain users have both public and private keys. Bitcoin users have a public key, however, there is also a private key, but the guarding is higher. Because the hackers get access to the private keys, it will be a cakewalk for them to steal their bitcoins easily. Bitcoin encrypts data using a private key public key system. The public and private keys are inextricably linked. It's relatively simple to produce the public key from the private key, but it's nearly tough to do the opposite. This is due to the integer factorization process, which connects the private and public keys. In the event you take a long number, the classic computers of today will take years to crack it. In that way, Bitcoin is safe from the classic computers. Moving on to the next aspect, the Bitcoin miner validation. Bitcoin uses a proof-of-work system wherein the miner has to answer the mathematical puzzle. Miners are nothing but Bitcoin nodes, which are the powerful computers ready for a race to solve the problem using graphics processing units to validate the transactions grouped into mempool, a common pool. In short, a computer algorithm creates cryptographic content till the last block, which comprises a long alphanumeric string. After validating transactions, miners will make transactions from their pool to the next available block. The miner who is able to solve the problem will broadcast it in the network, and other miners can verify because the problem is asymmetric. With that, the calculating miner has created a new block and recorded the transactions from the mempool into it. The process is quite complicated to understand, and even today's regular computers cannot hack it. But whether is it possible for a quantum computer? The Bitcoin network's computing ability uses the current computing technology of bits, the smallest unit of storing information. It will only take in binary numbers, 0 or 1, at any given time. On the other hand, quantum computing technology does not rely on bits. It uses qubits, or quantum bits, which have the capacity to hold both 0 and 1 and a superimposed state of both at the same time. This system has significantly more power than the current computer system. Major companies all across the world are researching quantum computers. However, it is also true that the computer will take quite some years of research and experimenting to come into its true form as a commercial version in the market. Till then, the blockchain and other supportive networks are safe for now. But the threat has not gone. It will come and strike. Blockchain has added significant interest to its platform, and the new technology is currently being adopted by a lot of businesses all over the world. There are businesses and teams researching how to crack the blockchain server, and that will be possible once the quantum computers are operating fully. Considering the potential impact of a sudden release of quantum computers, the security of blockchain will drastically reduce. Businesses, governments, and communities will have experienced a tremendous amount of time and resources to implement blockchain by that time. They'll soon discover that their investment isn't worth anything. To avoid a situation like this, blockchain communities should take steps now to address the threat of quantum computing. It is a fact that quantum computers can break the encryption technology used in blockchain. However, there is a window of 10 years or so for the quantum computer to actually be able to break the encryption algorithm used in Bitcoin. Therefore, it is time for the largest cryptocurrency to start preparing for its security from now if it does not want to lose face-off with the supercomputer. And that was all for today's video. Thank you for watching. If you found this video informative, and make sure to hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and turn on the post notifications to always stay updated. Comment below when you think quantum computers can destroy Bitcoin. And we will see you all at our next one. This is Alex, signing off.